Very good noon, dear students. Let us continue the phenomenal woman again. Yesterday we have discussed about phenomenal woman, that is the author Maya Angelou, and we know all about what race she belonged to and what she was fighting for and what she felt about herself and what about the womanhood. All that we have discussed yesterday, and today we will see the poem Phenomenal Woman actually. Okay, and see here, the word that she uses, the phenomenal, it is twofold in this poem. One most often defines the word as meaning extraordinary, phenomenal means, and impressive. That is what she was. And Angelou is certainly revealing in being an extraordinary and impressive woman herself. This is what she stresses there in the poem. And the word phenomenal is also synonymous with unbelievable, being from the race which was controlled and ruled and which was made the slave in the American race. She represents that, she hails from that race, but still she becomes an impressive woman, an extraordinary woman, and that is what she calls herself as phenomenal woman. So as she chooses to call herself phenomenal consciously, she seems almost incredulous that she is lucky enough to be a woman. She feels proud about herself being a woman. In her second stanza, the poem I will read at the end, okay? Before reading that, I'll tell you what it is about and what actually she brings in this poem, okay? And in her second stanza, she moves away from women and begins to discuss the spell she had over the men she encountered. The spell, that is what she told in the, like honeybees, the men surround her. She told, I told you yesterday in the class. So her attractiveness goes beyond the physical, because color was dark. It is something innate inside her that makes her so irresistible to men. Easily, whenever she stood there, whenever she talked there, whenever she faced the challenges, then men were easily attracted towards her. While women can change the way they look, Angelou hints that they will never be able to replicate what she naturally possesses inside herself. So she was not after any makeup or anything like that, as the modern women do. Okay, and this idea continues into the third stanza, the further next third stanza, where Angelou discusses the fact that even men cannot pinpoint what it is about her that is so irresistible. They were also wondering about what actually is there in her that attracts them towards her. That is how the innate quality, innate strength of this Maya Angelou was the only reason for her to stand and face the racial discrimination. Okay, so her answer to them is that she is a woman. That's what I told you in the previous class, that it is a blessing in disguise for her, a gift of God to be a woman there. Okay, and she is saying unbelievably, I am a woman, I am an extraordinary, amazing woman, that is who I am, she tells her. So in the last lines of the poem, Angelou speaks directly to her reader after explaining her appeal to her audience, that she explains that she does not need to draw attention to herself. Even if she is for herself, she does something on her own for herself, but then also people get attracted towards her. She does nothing additional to attract anybody to her, but her very nature is so attractive, so fascinating, that she stood there like that as a woman. Okay, because she is a woman, a phenomenal woman, she has the confidence and pride to walk with her head held high. This is what she mentions, reveals in the poem, that she never bent or never bowed her head to anybody or anything. Okay, so let us come to the poem. This is how it reads. Pretty women wonder where my secret lies. The first line I quoted yesterday. I am not cute or built to suit a fashion model's size. The next line. Look at the third line. But when I start to tell them, it is as if she is talking to addressing the people or the audience. Okay, so very simple language is used here, unconventional rhyme scheme and not lengthy lines, very short lines are used here. You will easily understand. Just I go on reading, and whenever you get a doubt, then you can stand up and ask, no problem. Okay, so the third line, but when I start to tell them, they think I am telling lies. So I say, it's in the reach of my arms, She tells just, it is in the reach of my arms, the span of my lips, the stride of my step, the curl of my lips, I am a woman. This is where that lies. Okay, I am a woman, phenomenally, I am a woman, phenomenal woman, that's me. This is the first one. Second one, look at the second one. I walk into a room just as cool as you please, without drawing anybody's attention, without making any noise, any sound, without giving any sign of that I am entering into a room. I just enter. And to a man, the fellows stand or fall down on their knees. As and when I enter into the room, then the men start to fall on their feet, on their knees. Then they swarm around me like honeybees, I told yesterday. See, that's what she brings in the next line. I hive of honeybees. I say, it is a fire in my eyes. Look at that. Confidence was reflected in her eyes. So bright and so confident, so bold look that she had on her face. That was what was the reason for the men to be fascinated or attracted towards her. Okay, it's the fire in my eyes and the flash of my teeth. When she spoke, when she smiled, when she responded to them, then it was the flash of her teeth that attracted men. The swing in my waist, whenever she walked, the swing in her waist and the joy in my feet that she enjoyed doing or standing there and talking, addressing people or the her followers in the from the black Negro race. Okay, and the joy in my feet. I am a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman, that's me. See there, how she stresses there, phenomenally she is a woman, then she continues, phenomenal woman, then she tells, that's me. Stresses that it is me only, she that she is referring to herself, that that's me, that's me, again and again. Okay, men themselves have wondered how beautiful or how attractive, how fascinating this lady is. They try so much, but they can't touch my inner mystery. So where the beauty of this Angelou lies, that's what they wanted to touch, that she feels. Proudly she tells that, my inner mystery, they try so much to touch, but they can't touch. When I show, I try to show them, they say, they still can't see. Whenever she tried there to convince them, to tell them that this is the secret of her beauty, then also they could not understand or they could not see her strength and her ability. I say, it's in the arch of my back. Then again she tells, of course you may take it in a funny way, that it's in the arch of my back, the sun of my smile. See, this is what I usually tell you in the class, that smile, it improves your face value. So it was the secret of her strength there. That's the sun of her smiles. The ride of my breasts as a woman, the grace of my style. Her style, whenever she appeared there on stage or on screen, then her grace, that confident appearance on the screen, that attracted men. So I am a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman, that's me. These four lines repeat four times in the poem. Okay, continuously she uses there. Very less is there about the details here, but there is a lot to think about her mind and read about her mind, that confidence and that faith in herself, that pride in herself. Okay, so now you understand just why my head is not bowed. That's what I told you previously, that she never bowed her head for no reason. I don't shout or jump about or have to talk real loud. When you see me passing, it ought to make you proud, I say. So people simply felt proud whenever she passed by them. This is what strength she had. Okay, it's in the click of my heels, the bend of my hair, the palm of my hand, the need for my care, cause I am a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman, that's me. This is where the poem ends. Okay, I hope you understood the poem Phenomenal Woman, and if you have any questions, you can raise, we'll discuss further. Thank you.